Good evening, everyone. Iowa's multibillion-dollar corn and soybean industry could be in serious trouble tonight.
The U.S. Department of Agriculture now believes Iowa is suffering moderate to severe drought conditions. Patrick Bell has the very latest on this story. Patrick.
Yeah, Stacey and Kevin, it's a bad situation growing worse by the hour for Iowa farmers, some of whom tell me they're expecting up to a 30% drop in their corn and soybean yields.
People keep asking me when we get a little bit of rain if that helps. And I say, well, it just puts us on life support for one more day. We're just on life support day to day. If we can get the tenth of an inch rain here, a half inch there, it just prolongs things another day before we have a disaster.
But for farmers like Andy Hall,
it's just kept us hanging on.
Triple-digit temperatures combined with little to no rainfall means entire crops are now in jeopardy.
Crop failure is the worst fear, but you know, even a 10-20% reduced yield is a big impact on any farmer. And
especially when you have several thousand acres of parched central Iowa farmland.
The top yield is gone. That big yield that we always hope for is gone.
Regardless of what
rain we get.
Most of the corn belt's kind of in the same situation. In fact, much of the wheat belt for that matter as well.
State climatologist Harry Hilliker says much of the state is in a moderate drought, which could worsen quickly.
Yeah, basically, if we don't get, you know, significant rainfall, you know, very soon, you know, whatever soil moisture reserves we got will be completely depleted.
And will that take us into a greater drought?
Yeah, much, much more so.
Still, Iowa's not as bad as what farmers are facing in Indiana, where many corn stalks have no ears, no silk, nothing.
Our paycheck comes in the fall, and it's going to be pretty short this year if we don't get some rain.
Several hundred miles to the west, Andy Hall also hopes for precious precipitation.
If it started raining now and cooled off, we could salvage a good yield, a good crop, but the excellent crop is gone.
And those low yields could also mean low supplies of feed corn, which could mean in turn livestock farmers will likely pay more to feed their animals. And when milk and beef goes to market, Stacy, consumers will end up paying more at the grocery store.
Okay, Patrick Bell live in the newsroom tonight. Thank you, Patrick.